what Leah's doing right now isn't so shocking to me. I actually started seeing some behaviors that I really kind of was like, "Ooh, this is not a nice person." And that hit me in 2008. We ended up becoming pretty close friends in early 2000s. She was at my baby shower in 2007. I was at her baby shower, birthdays, hanging out at her house, karaoke parties. So we got to be pretty close in, I think, 2000 to about 2007. Once she had her kid, she definitely went into the I'm a new mom mode and didn't see her as much. But it definitely hit me in 2008 at her sister's wedding. I was 8 months pregnant, and I was waddling in to go pee, as very pregnant people do, and I opened the door to the lobby, which is where we had entered, and she looked right at me and said to somebody to her side, she goes, I thought we closed this door to the public. And I was like, oh, your friend, the 8 month pregnant person, has to go pee, and that's where you're at. And I definitely, that was it for me. I was like, got it. I see where she's at now. And it definitely started, I think, when she became friends with Jennifer Lopez. Like, she definitely started becoming very self-important. There were so many times when, like, one of our best friends sent out an email, like, hey, let's go to Disneyland for my birthday. And there was, like, 10 of us on the email. And they're all everyone knew each other and pretty trusted group. And she had a real problem that she wasn't blind copied on it. It's like, this is a Disneyland we're talking about, like, to your friends, and you want to be blind copied? So there's little clues that there was things that were not quite right, and her feeling very important, I think falsely. You could always tell that there was a dark side that would sometimes pop up. She was constantly like digging for salaciousness or gossipy stuff. And when you're joking around and it's lighthearted, that's fine. But that's kind of like a little indicator that you know, that's where she lives. Like, that's her little wheelhouse of, you know, what she likes to talk about. And, you know, looking for dirt, always having, you know, the trash magazines around and, you know, looking for stuff on other people or herself. And, I mean, that's truly what I think Leah's doing here, is trying to keep herself in the limelight. I mean, that's really what I think this is about, because I think her career started going downhill, or, you know, the big shows she was on, it's no longer on, and she needs money. And, you know, what bigger thing to give her money is sensationalism. And, you know, I think that's what this is, a certain extent. Like, I believe she's even said, you know, if it wasn't for Scientology, who knows where she'd be, because she knows she has that darkness. She's always been trying to control her inner beast, you know, and she knows she can get nasty and mean, and Scientology was continually helping her to, you know, be a kinder, nicer person, being happier with herself. You know, the beast was too much for her, and, you know, with her career, maybe, you know, not being on a hit show, I don't know, she got fired from the talk, paychecks being of an issue, and her mom, that's another subject, in her ear. And it's like, hey, what better way than to make some money is to just try to attack Scientology?